Hello everyone. In this video tutorial, we'll see how to program uric acid kit on any semi-automated biochemistry analyzer. Please note that in this video, we are using the kit manufactured by Anamol Laboratories Private Limited. To program the kit on any semi-automated biochemistry analyzer, there are multiple information required which is mentioned in the instructions for use by the manufacturer. Using this information, you can program any semi-automated biochemistry analyzer. Let's see how we can do it. The first thing that we need to do is switch on the instrument and come to the main menu. Once we are at the main menu, select Test Operations and then select Add New Test. Here there are multiple options available in which we have to select Endpoint because uric acid is an endpoint parameter. Now as you can see, there are multiple information that needs to be entered over here. The first information that needs to be entered is the name of the test. Here you can enter any name which is suitable according to your laboratory settings. In this video, we are entering UA as the name of the test. Once you have entered the name, press the option Enter and come back to the home screen. The next information that needs to be entered is primary wavelength. The information of primary wavelength can be seen in the instructions for use, where the manufacturer clearly mentions at what wavelength the absorbance needs to be taken. So here we will select the option of primary filter and select filter number 1. And from the list we will select the wavelength which is mentioned in the instructions for use. As the manufacturer has not given any information about secondary filter, we will leave this option and keep it blank. Press Escape to come back to the home screen. Next, we have to enter the information of the temperature or the flow cell temperature. Again, this information can be seen in the instructions for use, where the manufacturer clearly mentions at what temperature the absorbance needs to be taken. In this case, the default temperature mentioned is 37 degrees Celsius, hence we do not have to change it. Next, we have to enter the information of KF or kinetic factor, which is to be maintained at 1.0. Next, we have to enter the information of volume or aspiration volume. Now, aspiration volume can be maintained at 500 microliters. But if you are doing the entire test in 500 microliters, then aspiration volume can be reduced up to 400 microliters. Next, we have to enter the information of units. To check what units you have to enter, you have to see the instructions for use and check the units that is mentioned in the standard concentration. Whatever units are mentioned in the standard concentration, same unit we have to enter into the software. To do this, we have to select the option of units, and from the list we have to select the unit that is mentioned in the instructions for use. Next, we have to enter the information of lag time and read time. Now, because uric acid is an endpoint parameter, this is to be left blank. Next, we have to enter the information of blank settings, whether reagent is to be used for blanking or distilled water is used for blanking. Again, this information can be seen in the instructions for use, where the manufacturer clearly mentions whether reagent or distilled water is to be used for blanking. Now in this case, because reagent is to be used for blank, we will select the option of blank and then select option yes. The next information that needs to be entered is QC. If you are running any quality control serum, the value of normal or abnormal range can be entered over here. The next information that is to be entered is normal range of patient sample. Now the laboratory has to ascertain its own normal range. But if the laboratory has not established its normal range, the values that are mentioned in the instructions for use can be entered over here. In this case, you have to enter the lowest and the highest value as per the instructions for use. To do this, select the option of normal range and select option yes. Next, select the option for low and enter the lowest value what is mentioned in the instructions for use. Press Enter once you have entered the value. Next, select the option High and select the highest range that is mentioned in the instructions for use. Once you have entered the value, press escape to come back to the home screen. Next, you have to enter the value of standard, whether the standard is available in the kit or not. Again, this information can be seen in the instructions for use, where the manufacturer clearly mentions whether the standard is available in the kit or not, and if yes, what is the concentration of standard. Here we have to select the option of standard and select option yes, because standard is available in the kit. Next, we have to enter the concentration of standard. To do this, first we have to select the number of standards available in the kit. In this case, only one standard is available in the kit. Hence, we have to first select option 1. As you can see, now the option to enter the concentration is open. So now we can enter the value of concentration. Press escape to come back to the home screen. Next, we have to enter the value of limit set or reagent linearity limit. Again, this information can be seen in the instructions for use, where the manufacturer clearly mentions what is the linearity of the kit. To enter the value, select the option of limit settings and then select reagent linearity limit and enter the numerical value which is mentioned in the instructions for use. Press enter and escape to come back to the home screen. Now, as you can see, whatever information is required to program the software has been added over here. So now we can select the option save, and the program will be saved in the instrument. To view the program, go to list test and go to the screen where our program has been saved. In this video, our program has been saved on position number 76. To open the program, select the option. If you want to run any patient sample, select the option Run, and further the instrument will guide you how to take the absorbance. Thank you, and we hope this video has been helpful for you.